Hi, I'm Jason Mayhew from Forney Industries. I'm the Senior Manager of Welding Products and Engineering. And we're going to take a closer look at the 190 and the 140 MP machines, which is multi-process machines. These machines are capable of stick welding, MIG welding, or TIG welding. Let's take a little bit closer look at the machines. You notice the 140 and the 190 do look very similar to each other. The main difference is the power input and then also the power output. The 140 machine operates off of 115 volts and a 20 amp input. The 190 machine operates off of 230 volts and also has an adapter plug that comes with it, so you can operate off of 115 volts as well. Very versatile machine. Of course, the 140 machine has an approximate maximum output of 140 amps and the 190 machine has an approximate output of 190 amps. So both very good machines. If we take a look at the control panel, you'll notice that I can change to stick welding mode, I can change to TIG welding mode, I can change to four different MIG welding modes. You'll notice that there's a 2T and a 4T trigger mode. The 2T trigger mode is for short welding. The 4T is a trigger lock, and that's for better for long welds. There's also manual and synergic modes as well. When we're in stick welding mode, I'll be adjusting the amperage on the left here. On the right, I'll be adjusting my hot start function. On the TIG welding mode, I'll be adjusting the amperage. If I'm hooked to local, if I'm hooked to remote, I'll be adjusting the amperage with my foot pedal. On MIG welding, you'll notice if it's in manual, I'll be adjusting my wire feed speed and then my voltage separately. And if it's in synergic mode, I'll be adjusting wire feed speed here and then percent thickness on the right hand side. You notice here on the LED indicator, if it's solid green, it's 230 volts. If it's blinking green, it's hooked to 115 volts. There's an over temperature indicator here, as well as a fault indicator here. When we talk about synergic welding as it applies to MIG welding, what that essentially means is the welding machine is a smart machine. It monitors the arc, optimizes the arc, reduces spatter, and really just produces an overall better quality weld. Synergic welding is great for that first time user that has trouble finding the sweet spot. It's very easy to find the sweet spot in a synergic mode. Let's take a look at some of the other features on this machine. You'll notice that this machine comes with a Euro style disconnect. Very easy for maintenance, replacing the liner, troubleshooting wire feeding problems, things like that. It has a negative terminal and a positive terminal, and also an Amphenol connection. The Amphenol connection is for attaching a spool gun, attaching a TIG torch, or attaching a foot pedal as well. So this machine has a lot of versatility built in. With the 190 machine, you get a 15-foot power cord, great for the common garage. The 140 machine comes with an 8-foot power cord. However, if you want to use a heavy, like 10-gauge extension cord with the 140 machine, that's possible. I wouldn't use one any longer than 25 foot long. Remember, if you're using 115 volts, make sure there's no other devices plugged in or robbing power from the circuit. It really needs to be a dedicated circuit. These machines will use all the power that you can give them. It's necessary for giving the maximum output of these machines. In some cases, if you have a load on a circuit, these machines will actually shut themselves off to protect the machine. So let's take a closer look inside the welding machine. You'll notice that we have a premium de-spooler back here. We've spent a lot of time focusing on optimizing the wire feed, which then gives you a nice smooth arc. So it comes off of the de-spooler. It's easy to adjust the tension. You can use 4 or 8 inch spools. It goes in through the inlet guides. You'll notice there's a cast aluminum drive system here. Also, you'll notice that both the idler and the drive roll are both geared, which then helps push the wire through the torch. When we come up to this area, we can change the polarity if we're running solid wire or flux core wire. And then also we can adjust slope of the motor and the burn back time as well. Over here is our switch for local or remote. Normally you'll stay on local, but if you have a foot pedal hooked up to the machine. You'll flip this over to remote, and then the foot pedal will adjust the amperage. Both the 190 and the 140 MP machines are great for maintenance and repair, light industrial, farming and ranch applications, automotive, and even just general fabrication. The 190 machine is capable of running up to 5/32 stick electrodes, and the 140 machine is capable of up to 1/8 electrodes. I would highly recommend using an 030 MIG wire in both these machines, but if you need to, you can also use an 035 MIG wire. Both these machines are covered with our standard 531 Forney warranty. If you have questions on the warranty or just general questions about the machines, please visit askforney.com or forneyind.com.